والإسلام ديني ومحمدا رسول الله.
In the name of Allah, the most gracious and the most merciful. Attending invitations in Islamic teachings. The life journey of the Prophet Muhammad is an expansive ocean of knowledge, boundless and limitless. His teachings are not devoid of wisdom, making him an exemplary figure for all times. His demeanor, which never harmed others but rather pleased them wherever he went, especially when attending invitations, exemplified perfect etiquette. It is mentioned that the Prophet Muhammad advised us that upon entering someone's home as a guest, we should do so with humility in our mannerisms, whether it be in our gait or in how we sit. However, if the host is not yet fully prepared, we should not hasten to enter. When taking a seat, we should not gaze too intently at others who have arrived earlier, nor should we occupy a seat that inconveniences others, but rather sit in an empty space. It is best not to sit directly in front of others unless there is no other vacant spot available. Similarly, it is not good to crowd around other guests, even if the host directs guests to a specific area. It is advisable to comply with the host's seating arrangements to maintain order in the gathering. Furthermore, upon entering, it is good to greet and acknowledge those nearby. It is also part of etiquette to stand if other guests stand when a dignitary arrives. As stated in the hadith of the Prophet, part of humility for the sake of Allah is lowering oneself when in a gathering. It is advisable for male guests not to sit facing the door of the women's quarters in the house, nor facing curtains behind which women may be. Guests should also avoid fixating on the food serving area, as it reflects poorly on one's character, greed. When in front of the meal, it is also recommended for the host to wash their hands before guests do so, as it honors the guests and enables the host to finish eating sooner, allowing new guests to join the meal promptly. If a guest needs to perform ablution, it is encouraged for the host to indicate the direction of the Qibla, the location of the bathroom, and the area for ablution. This was practiced by Imam Malik with Imam Shafi'i. If a guest witnesses something inappropriate in the room, they should rectify it if possible. If not, they should voice their disapproval and leave the place. Examples of inappropriate things include seating made of silk, dishes made of silver and gold, images of animals on the walls, presence of music and entertainment, opposite genders not covering their heads, and if a rented room contains prohibited images, they should be removed or the guest should leave. Similarly, it is also part of guest etiquette that if thin and transparent curtains are hung, which do not provide privacy from heat or cold, the guest may open them as needed, as there is no benefit in keeping them closed. These etiquettes and recommendations should be followed if possible. However, if they cannot be followed, especially in today's times where leaving a gathering due to something inappropriate may sadden the host, then it suffices for the guest to internally detest the prohibited actions and be present only for the purpose of visiting.
And Allah knows best. Hopefully, this is all useful.
وَمُحَمَّدًا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ